The concept of Camp Harvest came from a bunch of people in student ministry talking about how camp has impacted each one of us and wouldn't it be great to have a camp of our own. And so I remember praying and investigating and talking to different camps, and then God showed up and provided us a place that we now call Camp Harvest, just north of Grand Rapids, Michigan.
I remember getting there and just seeing this magnificent piece of property that the Lord had provided. And long before we even imagined where the first cabin would even be, we just stopped and prayed about the changes and what He would do in the lives of the people that would step on there.
Camp is a unique environment. You get kids away from the distractions of life. When they first get there and you're like, all right, no phones, and they all groan like, no phones, how am I going to live without my... And then a day or two later, the guards come down, personalities come out, and God uses those moments.
I was always amazed at how different people with very different backgrounds and very different attitudes could have such a blast at Camp Harvest. And we got to know people that we thought, like, wow, we haven't talked to that kid all year long at youth group, but here up at camp, all of a sudden we really started this relationship. A lot of my lifelong friendships that I still have, honestly, were relationships that were built at that place.
I went to camp the first year as a camper in sixth grade and met like all of my small group girls, and we're still, for the most part, all together. So it's been really cool to be able to grow together.
94% of people who come to faith do so in their teen years. And so like these years, I think we have long seen the importance of withdrawing and having space to be able to literally put your phone in a box for a week and see God work.
Your encounters with God can become predictable when your life is so scheduled. But when you're at camp, you're watching Him show up in unpredictable ways, unscheduled ways.
We saw like a lot of families coming together, learning about what it means to be following the Lord as a family, and then just feeling the presence of the Lord there in the camp.
These campers worship different than when we would hear them worship at weekly ministry. It was the presence of God was there.
Something like sacred about that basement. Just all the times like I've encountered God in that space, you can feel His presence.
It's some of my favorite worship. Something about just like the white words on a black screen TV. It's just like not a huge show.
We've had students come in who have just struggled behaviorally. They've struggled to get along, they've struggled to fit in, they've struggled with addiction, they've struggled with so many things. And then to watch throughout the week, not only their behavior change, but their heart change, their countenance changes, the way that they interact with other students changes, their literal lives are being transformed.
There's miracles, you see miracles. You see students being brought from death to life, from darkness to light. I've known people who have come here with no church background and they leave on fire for Jesus.
You could be a helper in the kitchen. You could be a worship leader, you could be a leader of just a cabin. Kind of didn't matter who you were, like you were going to encounter the Holy Spirit. You were gonna walk into this property and be blown away. You just get a front row seat for an entire summer, seeing both students you know and students you don't know make these huge gains in their walk that you wouldn't get to see anywhere else.
Always startled when all of a sudden kids show up and make a noise. But to me, that noise is a joyful noise. And having a Christian camp here is a blessing to our community.
There's nothing particularly special about this place, but it's a place where God shows up year after year and life after life.
There's nothing in the lodge or the basement that is a spiritual recipe for success. It's everyone coming here expectant to see the Lord move. When you go home, like you don't have to look back and say, oh, I wish I could be at Camp Harvest. You can have the same posture of your heart to the Lord.
So many of those lessons I learned from John Smith, from my youth pastors, from the leaders that were pouring into me, God really used that and taught me a lot that I've seen just flow throughout all of my ministry life and opportunities, being a youth pastor, and now even a campus pastor.
Even in my walk today, when I like feel far from Him, I can always kind of like take myself back to what it feels like in that basement, to what it feels like in that cabin, and just remember and recount like all the ways that God has met me. You can't ever really forget that experience.
I've been to other camps, I've done other ministry, and Camp Harvest will always be the most special to me. There's just no place like it on earth.
Still today, you hear people say, When did you give your life to Christ? At Camp Harvest. When did you make that turn in your life? At Camp Harvest. What was a significant spiritual at Camp Harvest? To think that the Lord would allow a piece of property to be so greatly used. What a powerful testimony to the work of the Lord.
We're excited to be able to this summer look back on the last 20 years and see over 30,000 kids that have come to camp. About 3,500 kids have accepted Christ here for the first time. To celebrate how much God has moved in this property and just in this place. And at the same time, grow with excitement that we get to do this for another 20 years.
What's next is hopefully more of the same, more of the 20 years of awesome ministry that's already happened here.
God changing lives.